Let us see torque equation of induction motor. So torque developed by induction motor rotor depends on first rotor current, second rotor power factor, and third flux phi, which induces rotor EMF E2. Therefore, torque can be written as directly proportional to rotor current I2R, rotor power factor cos phi 2R, and flux phi. But we know that flux in machine is due to EMF E1 in stator, and E2 is proportional to E1. Therefore, phi is also proportional to E2. So I can rewrite this as I2R E2 into cos phi 2R. We know rotor circuit like this. This is SE2, R2, and this is what SX2. So for this rotor circuit we can write current, power factor, everything. Therefore, torque can be written as directly proportional to I2R. I2R is what? Voltage by impedance. So voltage is SE2, slip times E2, by under root R2 square plus SX2 whole square into E2 into cos phi 2R, that is R by Z. So R2 by Z is same, R2 square plus SX2 whole square. So torque is directly proportional to SE2 square R2 divided by under root Z square into under root Z square, that is what, Z square only. So it becomes R2 square plus SX2 whole square. Or I can replace this torque by, I can replace this proportionality by constant K, SE2 square R2 by R2 square plus SX2 whole square, where K is constant of proportionality and given by 3 by 2 pi NS. And NS is synchronous speed of RMF in revolution per second. So it is what, NS by 60. NS is RPM. So RPM by 60 is what, RPS. Therefore, I can write the torque, full load torque, TFL as 3 by 2 pi NS SE2 square R2 by R2 square plus SX2 whole square. Right. So this is the expression for full load torque. I want starting torque now. So for starting torque, we know at start, as speed is 0, slip will be 1. So if I put slip 1 in this, I will have TST as 3 by 2 pi NS into S is 1, so E2 square R2 divided by R2 square plus X2 square. This is what starting torque. right? I want what will be maximum torque. So condition for maximum torque, condition for maximum torque. So we know torque expression as 3 by 2 pi ns s e2 square r2 by r2 square plus s x2 whole square. So for given induction motor, this is constant k, resistance of motor rotor will be constant, leakage reactance of rotor will be constant, e2 is induced emf in rotor, that is also a constant value. Only variable is with in running condition speed, that is what slip. So if I differentiate this torque with respect to slip, I will get condition for maximum efficiency. Rather than differentiating this as s is available in both numerator denominator, I will simplify it as this is what I will write as k. I will divide both numerator and denominator by s. So it is what r2 by r2 square by s plus s x2 square, right? Now s square, so it is divided by, okay. Now s is available, variable is available in denominator, so if I differentiate this with respect to slip, then I will get condition for maximum efficiency, maximum torques for T max d by ds of denominator equal to 0. If I do this, I will have, this is what, minus r2 square by s square 1 by s d by ds of 1 by s minus 1 by s square plus x2 square equal to 0. So we got what, s square equal to r2 square by x2 square. So s will be plus minus, but slip cannot be minus because rotor speed is minimum speed is 0 and maximum speed can be ns, and at ns we know that motor will not run. So as s square equal to r2 square by x2 square, I can write as s equal to r2 by x2. So this is what condition, this is the slip at T max, slip at T max is R2 divided by X2. So when ratio of rotor resistance and leakage reactance are equal, then torque will be maximum. So that can be given by, therefore T max is K S E2. So S T max, I will write this as S M, say S M E2 square R2 by R2 square plus S M X2 whole square. So what is S M? S M is R2 by X2. Put it here, K R2 by X2 into E2 square R2 divided by R2 square plus R2 by X2 into X2 whole square. So X2 is to cancel. We have what, K E2 square R2 square by R2, this X2, R2 and R2, R2 square plus R2 square twice R2 square. So R2 square cancel. We got K, we got T max as K E2 square by twice X2. This is what expression for maximum torque. Right. If I want T to be maximum at start, So what will be condition? We know SM equal to R2 by X2 when T is T max. And at start, if you want maximum torque, so at start slip must be 1. So it is like SM is R2 by X2 equal to 1. I can say if R2 equal to X2, then starting torque will be what? T maximum. Right? And from this expression it is clear that maximum torque is independent of resistance, rotor resistance. It depends on E2 and X2. And the condition for maximum torque is when slip is R2 by X2. Then torque will be maximum. Right? So slip depends on R2, whereas T max is independent of R2. So this is about the torque of induction motor.